안녕하십니까. 국가기관 뉴스통신사인 연합뉴스가 한반도의 평화와 화해 그리고 통일을 논의하기 위해 마련한 한반도 평화심포지엄은 올해로 다섯 번째 맞이하는 심포지엄입니다.
This is the new Korean Peninsula regime. Today we will be discussing this new Korean Peninsula regime. The new Korean Peninsula regime aims at a peaceful Korean community where people on the Korean Peninsula end confrontation and conflict and recognize each other and live harmoniously together. When the promise of denuclearization and a peace treaty is followed through, when the arms control and disarmament based on mutual trust takes place, and peace is fully instituted, there will be a free flow of people between the two Koreas, and a community of peace can be finally realized.
The second element of the new Korean Peninsula regime is an economic community on the Korean Peninsula. The Kaesong Industrial Complex as well as the Kumgangsan Tourism Program benefited both North and South Korea. Therefore, connecting the roads and rails between the two Koreas will actually open the horizon, economic horizon, wider and also bring about a new order of cooperation in Northeast Asia as a whole. However, there are some conditions that need to be achieved to make this a reality, and both South and North Korea would have to make efforts with one common goal in mind. The third element of the new Korean Peninsula regime is to bring about change in the regional order. And our prosperity on the Korean Peninsula will enhance the prosperity of East Asia. The Korean Peninsula will no longer be a fault line that divides the continental and naval forces, but it would actually be a bridge that connects continent and naval powers and will become an economic corridor in Eurasia.
Why did the Hanoi summit fall through? Basically, it's because the U.S. presented a big deal. The big deal was about North Korea preemptively dismantling all of its nuclear weapons, chemical and biological weapons, and then the U.S. would guarantee a bright future in return. So it's all about a package deal. But North Korea had always maintained an action-to-action and gradual exchange approach. So this single package deal was very difficult for North Korea to accept.
A Yongbyon Technology University, so there's more than 300 buildings around that complex. And so if that facility, that whole complex is permanently and verifiably dismantled, that would actually, I think, account for about 60 to 70% of North Korea's nuclear capability. The Korean government in spirit supports this big deal, all for all suggestion by the U.S. government. We agree to that in spirit, but the implementation of it would have to be gradual and step by step. So the agreement will be on an all-for-all basis, but the implementation will be approached on a step-by-step basis. I actually think that the ball right now is in the North Korean court, that both North Korea and the U.S. needs to take a more flexible stance, then at least the U.S. should offer a security assurance aside from lifting sanctions. What about normalizing the diplomatic relations between the two countries of North Korea and the U.S., or for example, signing a non-infiltration treaty? These are measures of providing a security assurance, and my proposal is why not provide those assurances at the start of the process, not at the end of the process? The government, South Korean government's position is that we need to actually respect the position of both the U.S. and the North. Within the framework of national interests, we do need